Today, we're looking at a series of herbicide drift demonstration plots. The purpose of this demonstration is to show people the off-target movement possibilities and capabilities of different droplet size classifications. The application rates here were 64 ounces of glyphosate applied with a 30-foot sprayer at approximately 40 pounds of pressure, and this application was applied on June 28th. The first plot that we're going to be looking at is an XR flat fan plot. In this situation, the nozzle was an O2 size in terms of volume, and the spray droplet classification here would be classified as fine. In terms of the area that was sprayed behind me, we have the oats in the situation here, and you can see that's turned brown from the application of the glyphosate at 64 ounces, and the white pole in the background indicates that where the boom stopped. Immediately the area to the right or to the south of me is green, and that situation shows the fact that that was not applied. But because of the wind speed that occurred at the time of application, which varied anywhere between 5 to 17 miles per hour, we did have off-target movement into the untreated area that was not directly applied, and you can see the result in terms of damage to the oats when the fine droplets did move off target, and it's something we normally see with a fine droplet type of a nozzle on a flat fan. There's a percentage that's always fine and has the ability to move off target. The second plot that we're going to be looking at is a turbo flat fan. This style of nozzle from Spraying Systems Company is similar to a flood jet laid on its side. It has a turbulence chamber, but it is not air induction. It produces droplets that are more concentric and more even in size. The classification here would be a medium-sized droplet for the primary area. It can become small depending upon the pressure range that was applied. Again, it's an O2 nozzle size, and if we look back to our pole here at the end of the plot, and immediately to your right or farther to the south, you'll again see some off-target movement, maybe not quite as much as we had in the fine droplets classification for the XR flat fan previous to this, but certainly there is a percentage of droplets that are capable at normal pressures here at 40 to 45 psi of moving off-target. The next nozzle that we're going to be looking at is a style called a turbo twin jet. This is evident of nozzle styles that have a dual outlet or two openings as opposed to one outlet. Previously we looked at a turbo flat fan that had just one single outlet. This is the same style of nozzle. In this situation though, we have two openings. The idea behind two openings is to improve weed control, improve efficacy of pest control, etc. At one time looking at the possibility of this style of nozzle with twin outlets used for fungicide applications in soybeans, such as for the potential of soybean rust in the southern United States. In this situation, we would also call this a medium-sized classification, a droplet, although at higher pressures it can become small rapidly. In this situation, we have some off-target movement, but again, less than we had at the earlier plot where we had an XR flat fan or fine droplet. In this particular plot, we are looking at a nozzle style that provides a coarse droplet. This happens to be the situation involving a tip that actually uses an air induction principle. We have air-filled droplets, and they become much larger in the coarse category. This happens to be one that has a dual twin jet outlet from Spraying Systems Company. And in this case, the control pattern is very good, but also the degree of off-target movement has been lessened to some degree because of the size of the droplets, even though we are into some plot areas that were subject to increasing wind speeds during the application time. In this particular plot, we are looking at a nozzle style called an air induction flat fan. We are looking at a very much of a flat fan pattern, similar to the very first plot that we looked at, with the marriage of an air induction capability called an AIXR, operated at 40 PSI. This style of nozzle is capable of developing and delivering a coarse droplet as well as a a medium-sized droplet, very adequately within the different ranges. It's a nozzle style that works well with automatic spray controllers because of the fact that pressure may be going up and down and holding its pattern very well. But in this case, the principle and take-home message here is a flat fan product in terms of developing very good efficacy, but as well as coarse droplets. And in this situation, we seem to have a capability of holding that line in terms of drift management. This last style of nozzle is probably the most striking we have today in our field plot demonstrations. This happens to be a TurboJet induction style nozzle that develops and delivers ultra coarse droplets almost entirely through all pressure spectrum, anywhere between 15 to 20 pounds of PSI, well up to 60 or higher, making it very suitable for systemic products such as glyphosate, dicamba, other types of products, where it is very important to absolutely limit off-target particle movement to sensitive crops and sensitive areas downwind. In this particular situation, we've had wind gusts between 12 to 17 miles per hour that came through, and I think it's very striking in this situation that the droplet sizes were large enough not to move off-target, but yet adequate in terms of the control for giant ragweed that's in the plots, as well as for the oats, and gave satisfactory control, again at a fairly high rate of glyphosate, 64 ounces, but certainly efficacy was provided for that. But again, has a fit for systemic situations much more than it would be for a contact action, where we would probably not recommend its placement. So again, very specific, and will become, I think, a popular tip in the future for a lot of those systemic products and specific crops.